Hello, it's Sarah, and I'm back. I wanted to share these pocketbook charms that I've made. Totally inspired by Audrey, who is Windy Days on YouTube, and she doesn't do videos, but she had sent me this. Hopefully, I'm not going to do this too herky-jerky because I've been moving them around. This is the second time I filmed it because I moved too much. Audrey made this for me, and she sent it to me with the pen when my pennant, I had my pennant challenge, and I was so inspired because it's just petite and dainty, and I loved it. And I had made mine so chunky that when I took them apart to do them again, I had double the dangles that I ended up using and making double the charms. So I was so happy about that. So thank you, Audrey, for that inspiration. This, I just loved it. I thought that's enough. You don't have to get crazy and be super chunky. Just have a little bling. So this one's beautiful. I ordered these Eiffel Towers and fleur-de-lis, and I have another, a little Paris symbol. One of them has it, a couple of them have it. From an Etsy seller, I'm pretty sure, and I don't remember who, but I just Googled it. I Google everything, and then it shows pictures, and I find it. So, you know what? These aren't as petite as Audrey's was because my beads are just bigger. I have chunky beads. So, but I think they're a good quality, and hopefully people like them. I think I'm going to charge like 10 bucks for these. I feel like that's fair, and I'll see how it goes. If people, you know, accept that, then I'll be good. But if not, I'll slash my prices by the end of the day. I always end up slashing my prices. Because I don't really want to come home with anything. I want to just make a little bit of money that I can put toward more crafting stuff. And that's it. That's what I do. I do one show a year. And but these are just so pretty. Pricing is the hardest thing, you guys. I really, really need help. If you have any suggestions, I'm all ears. I just really... This one doesn't have any charms. It's just blues. It's so pretty. I really love this turquoise color, this teal. So there's really only like six charms, 3, 4, 5, 6 dangles, and possibly a couple charms. That's it. That's all I'm putting on there. Just keeping it real simple. Everything is glass beads, Swarovski crystals, and it's not, oh, I love this one. I love this one. I am a pink girl. I might have to keep this. This is so pretty. Here's the fleur-de-lis. It's a little tiny fleur-de-lis. The Eiffel Tower. Sorry, stopped me right in my tracks. And then just a variety of different beads from my stash. But good quality stuff. Not sterling silver, like I said, but it is good quality. And well made, I would say, you know. So I mean, I really try to put something out that's gonna last a little while. I've been wearing one of these for a while, like all summer, maybe even longer, and Liam loves it. I have to always take it off and give it to Liam whenever he sees it, and I enjoy it. It's just my bling that jangles all around when I'm you know, doing my thing. This one has beachy worm charms. A beach chair, an umbrella, a dolphin, and ice cream cone with kind of like oceany colors. So that one's pretty. Oh, I love pink and black. Love pink and black. Again, though, only about 6 dangles on each one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yep. This one has my little key, my key and lock that says made with love, and then just a key charm. And this big lobster claw clasp that you can hook it to your zipper, to your, like, whatever. I have these little metal rings that hold my handles on, so I hooked it on that. Look at this one. This one's a chunk, big one. I had these big pearls in different sizes. I just try to put the biggest one at the bottom, kind of anchor it, and then just kind of start smallish at the top and work my way down. I threw a little one in here, down here too. Oh, here's the Paris charm. It's like a little Paris sign that just says Paris. Love it. Love them. See, I love them. That's what the thing is like, and I know everyone's tastes are different, but when I love them, I think I should charge more. I don't know. It's so, oh my God. Look at this one. I love pink and green too. Look how pretty. Seriously, like that's really pretty. I hope this is showing up. That is so pretty. It just makes me happy. I love these beads. These are little floral beads. I've had these in my stash forever. I think they're like Chinese glass beads, and I got them at a bead convention. And then this is just whites with a big old Jesse James anchor down the bottom, just clear. And there's a skull charm with some bling. The fleur-de-lis again and the Eiffel Tower. I hope you can see these okay. This one's like white and grays, like gray and white with bling. And look at these rondelles. These rondelles are from those bracelets that you get at AC Moore. And I just cut them apart and I use them, but like, look at that. And then I put a bead cap on the bottom. This is a spacer bead, I forget what they call them. And I did that to the top too. But they're nice. They're good quality charms, you know what I mean? And I think that's it. So I just wanted to share those though. These are so, I hope, I mean, 10 bucks. I think that's good, maybe seven. It's horrible. The pricing part is the hardest part for me. I really struggle with it. I try to, because you know, the people that come, they're not wealthy people. They're like looking for, I mean, some people probably have money that come, but I don't know. But they're just looking to get a handmade gift and stuff. And I always, people are very complimentary, regardless if they buy from me or not. They always have nice things to say. So I come home, my head's quite a bit bigger when I come home that night. But, and I generally do pretty good. I mean, all I want to do, like I said, is just make room in my craft room to make more stuff. So I just want to, you know, get these out of here and move some more stuff in. So thanks again, Audrey, for the inspiration. These are so fun to make, you guys. And thanks for watching.